Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com, and today I'm going to show you how to create a cinemagraph. A cinemagraph is basically a living photo, and it's not really new. They've kind of made a resurgence over the last couple of years and become really popular right now, but I remember back in 2005 I actually wrote a tutorial on how to do these in my How to Wow Photoshop for the web book. And I actually called it a living picture back then. It was 11 years ago of now. So, you know, if things go around, they come around, go around. So I'm going to show you how to do it here using a video. So here's a video that I shot just recently of Tiffany. Actually, this was last week at Adobe Educators Summit. So here we go. We can see we've got her kind of standing there in the breeze. I'm just playing the video back right now. And this was shot on a Canon 5D Mark III. And we can just kind of see there's a lot of video going on. So the goal here is to freeze this into a photograph and just kind of have her hair and the tassels moving. And then we can loop it. And then you could upload it to your website as an animated GIF or whatever. It'd be a small file size. And it can endlessly loop and create this movement. It's kind of a cool effect. So as you can see, we've got, you know, 16 seconds here. It's way too long. Now, just to let you know, if you don't see the timeline here, you go up under Window, Timeline, and you'll see the timeline there. Now, this tutorial will work in Photoshop CS6 or CC. Earlier versions have different animation engines. Now, to get the video in here, you just choose File, Open, and then you just choose the video, and it will open here, and then we've got the timeline. So what we want to do is, first thing, is break this down to a short loop where the action is happening. So we're going to grab the playhead here and just pull it across. This is known as scrubbing. So what I'm doing is I'm looking at the movement around here in the tassels and around here in the hair. I'm also noticing she's blinking about once a second. So let me just play this back. And what we're looking for is a consistent loop where the wind is blowing about the same. Notice as we get near the end of the clip here, the wind starts to pick up a little bit and really starts to whip things around, which is good. So what we want to make sure is, one, her eyes are looking in the same direction. We don't want them when they're looking in different directions. We don't want her blinking, and we want a consistent movement here with the body. So we're just kind of looking at it. So as you can see there, we want to pick that up right on a blink. So we don't want her blinking, so we're going to say about here is good. So we're going to trim the beginning, just click and drag it across, and then release, and that will bring it to the end there. So let's have a look and see what we've got now. So we're just looking for a short little loop there, maybe right after her blink there. Let's pull that back. So we've got a couple of seconds there. Now we want to check this to make sure that it's looping correctly. First thing we can do is just expand our timeline a little bit. This is not changing the duration of the video at all. All it's doing is just giving us a little bit more to play with here on our timeline. Now if you want to know more about video, I have two actual full training tutorials on working with video in Photoshop. I have a free one on YouTube, and then I have a couple of more in-depth courses. So anyway, let's have a look here. What we're going to do is click this, and we're going to choose Loop Playback. Now by doing this, this will enable us to look at a loop. So when it gets to the end, it will go back again. So make sure that's turned on, and then when we hit the play, notice it's going to go all the way through and then play again. So let's just watch that. And what we're looking for is just any sudden jumps. So you can see I kind of get a little bit of a jump there. And in fact, you can use grids. I'm just going to hit Control R for rulers. And then I can actually pull out a grid. And we can put that right on the side of your face to measure that to see if she moves. So we can see her head is pretty good. That's pretty consistent. We've got a little backwards and forwards, but that's not too bad. But I'm noticing here in certain areas, her hair is kind of coming out a little bit. So if we go here, we notice at the beginning there, go back here. Let's just measure that again. So the main bulk of her hair is about there. So let's move across and notice her hair comes in and out a little bit. And then when we get to the end, that's not too bad, actually. It's not too bad at all. I'm just going to pull it back a little bit and let's see how this loop looks. Yeah, we've got a bit more of a consistent loop there. So just don't be afraid to use these guides to help you measure things and find a nice loop. So that's a good base video for us to use. So the next thing we want to do now is we want to freeze this into a photograph. And that's super easy. What we're going to do is just find a nice frame that we like where her expression is good, which is right there. That looks good. So we're just going to duplicate this layer. So you can hit Control J or Command J on Mac for jump, or just drag into the new layer icon. And that's going to duplicate that video. Now we don't want this to be a video anymore. We want this top layer to be an image. So we just right click and then choose rasterize layer. Now we'll convert it to an image. And if you look on our timeline, notice it's right after the other one. We want these on top of each other though, not one after the other. And you might find if you click and drag, you can't drag that above. What you need to do is remove it out of the video group. So take that layer, which is an image, and click it and drag it above, and see that little line will appear there? Release, and notice now it's on a layer above the video. So let's just click and drag this across, and we're just gonna make it match. So now if we play, notice there's no movement, because what we have now is we're looking at our picture with our video underneath. All right, so we're almost there. Now what we need to do is just reveal the areas that we wanna have movement. And we can do that by using a layer mask. However, it's gonna be quite difficult to see where we've masked out because both of these layers look the same. If I hide that, you look underneath, and as we scrub through, it's pretty hard to tell, you know, what's video and what's an image. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put a temporary effect on this video so we can see clearly why we're masking. So I'm just gonna hide our layer. I'm gonna grab our video group there, just our video layer, and I'm gonna apply a hue saturation adjustment. So with the hue saturation, I'm just gonna drag this across and just give us some crazy colors, which we can hide later on. But now we can see where we're masking because we just wanna mask around the hair and around here and maybe the tassels. So let's grab our layer, which is the image, and we're gonna apply a layer mask. Notice this layer mask is filled with white, so it has no effect. Now we wanna paint away parts of the photograph to allow the video to display underneath. So we're gonna just click there, make sure we've got black for the foreground color, grab a brush, opacity set to 100, and I'm actually even just gonna turn off pen pressure for there because I don't want to have any, you know, partial transparency. I wanna just have a solid transparency. Although you could blend it nicely with that, but not everybody has a tablet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna paint around here so we can see the area of the hair. So we're just gonna paint around. I'm just gonna go over a little bit because we know that hair is gonna blow around. And we don't really need to go into her face. We don't wanna do that because we don't wanna get any blinking or anything like that. Let's just kind of go around here. I know this is going to move around. This feather is definitely going to move a little bit. And her hair here is definitely going to blow around. So let's just give it a little space over here for it to move into. And let's have a look now. And what we're going to do is just hide this hue saturation adjustment layer. And then we're just going to play. And we can see now we've got our hair and the feathers moving quite nicely. Notice up here it kind of warps a little bit if she's breathing. See in there? And it looks maybe a little odd. We can fix that. So what we're going to do is we're just going to turn this back on again so we can see that. And then what we're going to do is I'm just going to hit the X key. And what I want to do is just paint with white for the areas in here that I don't want this area to move at all in there. So let's have a look and see how that looks. We'll hide that. There we go. See, that's looking nice. We've just got that little feather blowing around a little bit and some of her hair here. Now, this doesn't quite match there. You see that? That feather kind of stops blowing about there. Or actually, let me see. Where does it start blowing? Yeah, see, it doesn't start blowing to about here. So what we could do is we could trim these two. So let me just open this up a little bit. Now, you can spend as much time as you want noodling around to get these perfect. I'm going to select both of these and then just pull across there. I don't think they're both going to move at the same time. No, they're not. So I'm going to go to there and then just, oops, hang on, let me undo that. Make sure that they're lined up nicely like that. So let's try the looping again, see how that looks. Oh, look at that. That's looking much better, much more realistic now. And once again, you know, you can spend as much time noodling as you want to get this perfect. But what I'd like to do now is I'd like to get a little bit of movement going in these tassels. So I'm just going to turn on our hue saturation adjustment again so I can see what's going on. Make sure I select black. Maybe make this brush a little bit larger, and I'm just going to paint over these tassels because I want to see these move around in the wind. I think it's going to add a really nice effect. And okay. So let's hide that. And now when we play this back, look at that. We've got some really nice movement going there. And we've created our basic cinemagraph. Now, I'll show you how to export this out, because what you want to do is you want to export it out as a GIF, as an animated GIF. Some people call it a GIF, some call it a GIF. Personally, I like to call it a GIF, but it doesn't matter what you call it. So we're just going to choose export, and we're going to go to save for web. Now, when we go to save for web, right now it's at 1920 by 1080. You can choose whatever size you want. I'm going to keep this locked in. And I'm going to set this to 650 width, because I want to put it on a WordPress blog. So I want it to be about this big. Make sure you choose GIF and not JPEG. All right, so there we go. And we can see what we've got there. So make sure you're not under original, but you're under optimized. And this lets you see what we've got there. Notice we've got 67 frames in here. We can hit the play button. And look, we can actually preview that GIF right in here. This will play smoother, of course, once it's all rendered. But right now we're just in the save for web view where we're looking at it. Okay, so we're just going to hit stop there. And notice we've got this set to 256 colors, which is the maximum. We pretty much want to do that. And whatever settings you've got here are good. We don't really need transparency, but it doesn't really hurt to have it on or off. And so what we can see here is we're looking at looping options. We want to change this to forever because you want this to loop entirely. Let's click the preview and have a look in a browser and see what our GIF is actually going to look like. So you can see up here, that's exactly what it's going to look like. It's going to look quite nice. It's going to play well. Now, as you can see, it's still quite big. We can reduce this by reducing the amount of colors. But once again, loading up 6 megs is a lot less than what you get for a video, especially if this is going to loop forever. So you're going to really just kind of decide about that. But in this case, I'd like to go for the full size. And then we're just going to hit save. All right, so we've got it here, and we're just going to call this cinemagraph.gif, and we're just going to hit save, and then we're going to save this out. All right, so we've saved it. Let's find it. All right, and here's our GIF there. So we can just hit the spacebar to preview it, and you can see that it's completely done. Okay, so if you want to display this on your website, you can upload this right now. Or if you want to display it on Facebook, you've got to upload it to your website and then link it, or upload it to a site like Giphy, and I'll give you the link for Giphy, where you can upload it there, and then you can play it. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I have a new tutorial every single week. Now, if you'd like to become part of the Cafe crew, hit the subscribe button right now, and you'll get a new tutorial every week. Once again, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. Smash that like button, give us a comment, and I'll see you at the cafe.